Oh, thank you, Lord. It should be, church, no surprise to any of us that some people are jealous.
That's right.
Amen.
They have no expectations of us. They don't understand why, God, why you want to use them. Why do you want to put them into greatness? Oh, thank you, Lord. But I come, thank you, Lord, to encourage you today. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. God is a good God. And I want to encourage you that what God has for us cannot be stopped. Unless we allow it. Now, if you believe it, I want you to say, tell your neighbor if you believe it, say
name.
What God
has for me.
It is for me. Moving into my greater requires progress. Do me a favor, say neighbor. I'm making progress. Let me go ahead and give you this last point. I'm trying to get on that way. I'm just gonna read it. But God is a good and mighty, mighty God. Point number three. Moving into my greater requires a God-given destiny.
Yes, amen.
Ah, truly the Lord is good. Destiny is simply, in simple terms, means God's purpose for our life. It is our appointed and our anointed future. Destiny is what God has predetermined for us to be.
Yes.
For us to become. By His divine will in His plan.
Say so.
Consider, thank you, Lord, the profound confirmation in Romans chapter 8 and beginning at verse 27. It says, and he, thank you, Lord, that searcheth the heart knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God.
Yes.
And we know that all things work together for the good to them that love God, to those who are called according to his purpose.
Yes.
And for whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brothers.
Yes.
Moreover, whom he predestined, though he also called, and those he called, those he also justified. And those, thank you, Lord, that he justified, he also glorified. Now, church, I don't mean no harm. I want you to understand that talking about a divine destiny for greatness, because of God's divine plan of salvation, God sent his only begotten Son, that while we were yet sinners, God commanded his love towards us. And Jesus for us. Thank you, Lord. We got to understand from where we come from. The Lord, hallelujah. For we were once sinners, now saved by grace. We are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, born again believers, washed in the blood of the Lamb, sanctified to the truth, and sealed with the Holy Ghost. Destined for greatness. My friends, I don't know about you, but I have decided within the depths of my spirit that I want everything that God has in me. And I'm moving into my greater, but I know that my greater requires a progress. Thank you, Lord. He's working on me. My greater requires progress. And I don't operator requires a God-given destiny. And I'm ready for it. Thank you, Lord. Because you told me, for I know the thoughts that I have toward you. Thoughts of peace and not of evil. To give you an expected end. I need to quit, y'all. But I need a witness before I go. Come on, Abraham. Abraham was destined for greater when God called him to come out from amongst your kindred to a land that you know not. And I'll make you the father of many nations. Come on, Moses, and give me a little bit. Moses was destined for greater when God called him from the burning bush, from being a fugitive, to be a great leader, to lead the children of Israel out of bondage to the promised land. Come on, David. Was born of a virgin Mary in a little stable.